Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
The Lord will come and will not delay. He will illumine what is hidden in darkness and reveal himself to all the nations. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the coming solemnity of your Son may bestow healing upon us in this present life, and bring us the rewards of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. I am the Lord, there is no other. I form the light.
We can't hear you.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. I am the Lord, there is no other. I form the light and create the darkness. I make well-being and create woe. I, the Lord, do all these things. Let justice descend, O heavens, like dew from above. Like gentle rain, let the skies drop it down. Let the earth open and salvation bud forth. Let justice also spring up. I, the Lord, have created this. For thus says the Lord, the creators of heaven, who is God, the designer and maker of the earth, who established it, not creating it to be a waste, but designing it be lived in. I am the Lord, and there is no other. Who announced this from the beginning and foretold it from of old? Was it not I, the Lord? Besides whom there is no other God? There is no just and saving God but me. Turn to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth, for I am God, there is no other. By myself I swear, uttering my just decree and my unalterable word, to me every knee shall bend, by me every tongue shall swear, saying, only in the Lord are just deeds and power. Before him in shame shall come all who vent their anger against him. In the Lord shall be the vindication and the glory of all the descendants of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response? Let the clouds rain down the just one, and the earth bring forth a savior.
Let the clouds rain down the just one.
I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, John summoned two of his disciples and sent them to the Lord to ask, "Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another?" When the men came to the Lord, they said, "John the Baptist has sent us to you to ask, 'Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another?'" At that time, Jesus cured many of their diseases, sufferings, and evil spirits. He also granted sight to many who were blind. And Jesus said to them in reply, "Go and tell John what you have seen and heard. The blind regain their sight, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised. The poor have the good news preached and proclaimed to them, and blessed is the one who takes no offense at me." The Gospel of the Lord. John the Baptist's role in salvation history was to call people to repentance, and he is the central figure during Advent in reminding us that we need to come to repentance in our lives. And one of the good ways to prepare for Christmas is to repent of our sins and use the sacrament of reconciliation, if we haven't already done that, in preparation for Christmas. The prophet Isaiah, speaking again 650 years before the birth of Christ, prophesied what life would be like when the Messiah showed up. The blind would see and the deaf hear, and people would have the good news proclaimed to them and be filled with joy. And we can point out this morning that there is no religion, no other religion on the face of the earth, in which Almighty God has foretold even hundreds of years and thousands of years before it happened and have it fulfilled. There is no other religion like that in the world. It's only our religion that can boast this. And Jesus even says it in that. He reminds John the Baptist of what is taking place in Jesus' ministry. And John the Baptist, knowing the scriptures, Isaiah, would recognize that he is the Messiah. They don't have to look for another one. He is it. He's doing the things that were prophesied in the past. And so it's a beautiful thought and a consoling thought that our religion is based on prophecies that go back hundreds and thousands of years ago, and that they are fulfilled and continue to be fulfilled because God is behind it, the one true God. Besides our God, there is no other God to worship except Him. And we have the assurance that He's real because He spans the generations. Let us present our needs and those of the world to our most gracious God. For all priests, religious, and lay servants of the Church, may the gifts of the Holy Spirit empower them in their ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may the blessed advent of Jesus bring peace among nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the suffering and sick among us, may Christ's healing presence be upon them and bring them comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present in this assembly, may God fashion our hearts in this Advent season to see Jesus more readily around us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed, may God's mercy bring them to eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray to God in thanksgiving for the inoculations against the virus, that God would make them effective in helping people to recover and save lives and comfort people who have the COVID. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of our youth, asking God to protect them and lead them to Himself. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we offer this Mass this morning for Louise Hammerschmidt. God, give her eternal rest and peace, the fullness of everlasting life in heaven. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, we thank you for hearing our prayers. We ask that you answer them according to your good and gracious will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth is given in human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all the church.
May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly, to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gerald our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Behold, our Lord will come with power and will enlighten the eyes of his servants. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God with your lives.
Thanks be to God.
And our prayer to Saint Michael.
Saint Michael, be our angel, and defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness of